thing, you know, offering ESOPs to retain employees is a buzzword in the industry. You know, everyone talks about, every employee nowadays talks about ESOPs. Now, what I understand is you have been successful in retaining employees for more than 10 years, some are more than 15 years without ESOPs. Now, what is that you have found is bigger compared to ESOP to retain an employee?
This is my personal view. ESOP is nothing but an intermediary instrument in between that conveys an organization or a founder's intent to share wealth. You need an instrument in between when the instrument has greater credibility than you. How do you convey? And there are two times when the instrument becomes necessary. If you are running, let's say, 10,000 man organization, you can't say, I'll personally appeal as a credibility. Right? You need an instrument somewhere in between. So to me, ESOP as a tool per se, what does it convey? It's about an intent of the organization to share any benefit of the organization for the people who created that benefit. Do you need a physical thing called ESOP is always a debatable point. It's just about how do you manage teams. Given, I said again, we've not been the B2C kind of organization that has 10 or 20,000 employees that needs to scale in that manner. With a smaller set of employees who've been there long term, it's possible to not need an intermediary instrument. You can kind of, if they have conviction in what the company or the founders are building and the conviction that there will be a fair way of sharing anything that gets created, you don't need that. You don't need an artificial instrument in between. That's first level answer. Second thing, just not to take away from those entities who be ESOP, right? It's a tested way to share that wealth. I mean, and you do have Indian corporates like Zoho, etc., who done it without that also. There are various models in which you can share. Those that are easily translatable and understandable, ESOP is a great tool in doing that. Now, again, I think goes back partly to functions. If you look at entities like institutions like, let's say, Tata's or Birla's over the years, I'm just talking Indian institutions, or even Reliance for that matter, they did not build those entities on the basis of ESOP. It has become necessary, again, it's like times. Today, if I were to found a company all over again today, it is impossible to not want to be on Twitter or LinkedIn, to your point, right? So similarly, if I start a company today, it would be necessary to follow that model because that's what the market today is. But I think we got lucky in terms of just creating that instrument. Right? Is that there is conviction among the employees who stayed, which is why they stayed so long, that there will be a fair sharing whenever that happens, and the tool in between is not so good.
Well said. I know it wasn't an easy question, but no one other than you could have handled it better. So thank you, Vasu.